let's start with Chitra. We will go in the same way. The Nakshatra Mantra of Chitra, the stories of Chitra, the remedies for Chitra, and the results for Chitra. Chitra means, Chitra technically means image. And Chitra is descriptive. So there is one very peculiar.
It's a Rashi course.
So Chitra is descriptive. And descriptive, I have noticed something about Chitra. Because the two padas of Chitra comes in Virgo and two padas of Chitra go to Libra. And the junction between Libra and Virgo, sorry, Virgo and Libra, is the junction where the zodiac is divided into half. So this life of this Chitra person, or whichever planet is in Chitra, but this is just something that I'm telling you just in the starting. You can use this for planets also if you have intelligence. If you don't have, don't do it. Okay, simple. I will not be explaining it again and again. Based on a recent feedback, right? So you can do it for the planets as well. Told. Okay. If you can do, all the very good. If you can't, leave it. So because the two padas of Libra comes in Virgo, and because the two padas of Libra comes in Libra, this person's life is like a football ball between the professional life and the personal life. Both the things are present there very strongly. And the person really gets a very hard time coping up with both the things. Generally indicate people who have to work, extra time, hard shifts, or women who have to also earn money and take care of the family, etc. So the tussle between the personal life and the social life, the tussle between the marital life and professional life is very strong, and that is something that cannot be ignored regarding this particular nakshatra. Another thing is Chitra means descriptive. So, you know, with Chitra, there is a problem. This Chitra should not open or start something even for a play. Like, you know, many of us can, you know, start doing something and can leave it in between. If you don't think that we are doing well with it, right? Like you can start learning astrology and then you can leave if you think that it is not working for you. But this descriptive Chitra cannot do that particular thing. Either they should not get in touch with that karma. They should not get in touch with that particular thing. If they ever get, then that is something which will never go away. Right? It is something that will never go away. For an example, if take a relationship. For Chitra, if a relationship starts, like for an example, I had a Chitra ascendant person, right? Virgo Chitra, but easily applicable to Libra Chitra as well. Chitra person, they got in relationship with a guy. It is interreligion. So one was Christian and one was Sikh. The interreligion. And the relationship started, and somehow the relationship haven't culminated in marriage. Okay. The Christian person got married to someone else. But their affair continued even after marriage. And there was a child also from that particular affair. And the problem is that the boy got married, not the girl. So whatever thing starts in Chitra that remains there, the interference, the coming back of that particular thing, you know, we always talk in this particular thing that, sir, you know, I interacted. Like, suppose you have been into some particular profession. And for some people, even after they leave the profession, people keep on coming in their life, inquiring about that particular stuff. right? That happens, right? That is what this chitra does. Like, if you have left a particular institute, suppose, and people keep on calling you that you have learned from that institute, how was your experience? That is an activation of chitra. Things keep on coming. Anything that is in chitra actually will never perish. That is always there, present. Keeps on coming, keeps on returning. In the fancy world of nowadays astrology, it is the past life karma that keeps on coming. Okay. The image of chitra is of a pearl. And you know how the pearl is made. In the shell, there will come a drop of water that is polluted. And that will make the pearl. So, you know, this is another trait that I say for chitra, and I have mentioned this earlier also. That chitra is someone who is very happy in their own personal life, own personal space, home sweet home. Until and unless external circumstances come and pressurize them. So it is generally a story where the external circumstances are coming, making the person unsettled and uneasy. And the chitra person will take up a long time to cope up with that particular external pressure or the external person. And that, in reality, will turn it into good. Okay. For an example, suppose that if the 10th Lord is in Chitra, then you have been into a job and your superiors suggest you to go to another branch or out of the country to look at the business relationships or look at the growth of the business for, say, 2 months or 3 months, which when proposed, you feel is gonna be very difficult for you to go and work there, right? But when you actually go there, after the end of the 2 months of your tenure in that particular place, you will find new opportunities of income. And, you know, like, we'll try to leave the company or live do your professional thing there only, or your position in the company is improved. Either ways, right? So this is the particular peculiar thing that I want to tell you regarding this. And because of the pearl, there is a very strong longing, or there is a very strong karma of getting separated by your child. Or, you know, the sense of, like, you made something with, like, you know, so much of your attention. You made something with so much of your, you know, so much of dedication and everything. And then you have to leave that thing, you have to lose that thing. That kind of particular trait is going to come with this, you know, chitra. So suppose, you know, like, chitra indicates a trait where someone is very close to their children because it is the only child. But that only child, they also have to, you know, like, and the only child want to study in foreign lands. And despite their attachment to the child, they will have to let him go. That will be very painful for the native itself. But for the betterment of the child, he will have to do it. Got my point? So that is also something that comes with chitra. Your most loved one, you have to leave because of their benefit. Chitra. Indrasya chitra ritam parastata satyam avastata satya. Chitra is moved by truth. Chitra is a truth speaker. they always want to go behind the scenes, like they are the followers of truth. They are in the search of truth. Generally, Chitra indicate people who are, you know, like well-versed with knowledge, spirituality, religion, dharma, like the eternal seeker of truth. Eternal seeker of truth in the signification of that particular planet, which is in Chitra. Let's say if moon is there, then the eternal seeker of the mental truth, right? This person will love to see how people, you know, that the statement, I love listening to lies when I know they are lies so that I can count the person kind of mentality. If the moon is there in Chitra, right? The person goes for truth. Whatever is the truth, the person wants to go for that. So the truth is very strongly attached with Chitra. And also this particular fact that this person will get confronted to the truths of life quite early. All of us find out at one point of time that this person was not meant for us. But for Chitra, this is very heartbreaking. It comes quite early and at quite unexpected times, leaving the person shattered. So the quest for truth and the confrontation of truth, both is there and both are painful. Indrasya Chitra Ritam. Ritam is right. And Chitra always have a pressure of doing righteous deed. They are always concerned where, whether they are doing some good or not. It is someone whose life is, as you know, I always say for Libra, that Varamahir have said, Dev Brahman Pujita, someone who worships gods and sages. So the same thing goes with Chitra as well. Chitra is someone who is always concerned about whether they are doing the right thing or not. Whatever they are doing is righteous or not, etc. They always want to do the right thing and they are always concerned about their karma and how they are coming across people. Multiple times, they will have to lose things. Once again, as I have given you the example of the child, that suppose they have only one child and that one child, they also have to let him go. Because according to them, if they don't let the child go to the foreign lands for his education, they will be doing something wrong with the child, is their approach. So they are generally moved by that good should happen with the other person. That is the prime focus that they have. That good should happen with someone. Right. I doing the right work, me doing the right karma. So, you know, it indicates a type of person who used to, you know, like in a relationship. In a relationship, if the partner comes across a better opportunity in relationship matters itself, Chitra is the person who will be like that he is best for you. You go. I am not good for you. Not realizing that the separation will cause harm to both of them. And the partner may not want to separate. But this Chitra one will superimpose that particular stuff. That no, you have to, no, you have to. So many times, this truth-seeking, right-doing approach is also detrimental for Chitra person also. Anyway. And Chitra don't have a very hidden life. They have quite an open life, which is known to almost all person, which is known to everyone. Because Chitra means something which is bright, which is clear, and which is excellent. Personal life is generally haphazard, but the professional life is very good. The person also manages to get name and fame. The person also manages to reach to an authoritative position in their professional field and in their professional life. Right? And the professional life is generally after crossing a considerable age, after crossing 35, 40, the professional life is good and excellent. The name, fame, recognition, etc. is there. Right? The person is like, you know, very safai lover kind of a person, you know, who is always on the run for that everything should be clean and etc. cleanliness. A cleanliness freak kind of a person generally have the habit of washing their hands, face, etc. multiple times. And someone who want to always be, doing good, as we already discussed, it gives a particular sense of, the clarity of character or the clarity of thought or the clarity of words. So multiple times, they're blunt with their speaking also because they want to be clear with what they want to say. They are also sometimes cruel on themselves because they want to be clear in what they are thinking or what they are feeling. Right. So this particular sense of... Right. So this, this particular sense of that I have to be clear in thought, I have to be clear in emotion, etc. Generally makes people dislike them. Because of course, no one likes a very straightforward person or someone who is very clear. Right? Make people dislike them, and because of this peculiar trait of themselves, they are harsh on themselves. Getting my point? Because they are so truth loving, so clarity loving, so righteous, that they do wrong with themselves only. Getting my point? So see, there are two approaches. Na? If you are in a relationship and you think and you come to know that your partner is still fascinated by the previous relationship. If you want a good relationship, you help them clear the doubt and remain in the relationship. But if you go by the Chitra approach, if you're like, oh, you still remember that person? Okay, fine. You go live with him. I will separate. So now once again, you are not concerned with their life. They are concerned with their life. So what they are going through, you don't know. But for sure, what you will go through is an extreme pain. That happens in Chitra. Okay. Now the Chitra is lauded by Indra.
I'm sorry, I just remembered something very funny.
Yes.
Four years ago, I came across a dating site. I don't do dating. I just came across that site on a talk show. The format of that dating site is this. A person lists all his shortcomings. I'm okay. Schizophrenic, I'm obsessive, I'm this, I'm that, I yell, I everything. So everyone on the dating site, lists his shortcomings. And if you see the picture of the founder, he's like a 50 years old person, of course, in the West. 50 years old person, his hair are coming out like this, and so all the people are laughing, kis tarah ki site hai ye. I have this disease, I have this disease. People listing even the disease. So I just remembered.
Yes, that is very much in the theme of Chitra. Of course, Libra person, though. Libra people have something to do with short hair. Libra is very much connected to short hair because the debilitation of sun. So it is not completely bald because of exaltation of Saturn, but debilitation of sun is also there, right? So Libra have a very strong peculiarity with hair coming up for men, and for women there can be multiple other things on hair, right, as well. Libra is lauded by Indra, and Indra is the conqueror. The one who conquers. So the story of Indra is very in tune with the story of Chitra. The person is born in not very good conditions. And the person have to conquer multiple things. Generally, there will be litigations in the person's life, which he will easily win. But the harassment will be there. Bad family conditions, the need for money, etc., the person have to face. It generally indicates a person on whom many people are dependent. And he have to improve the whole lives. He have to not improve only his condition, but to improve the condition of everyone. Every now and then his authority is being challenged. And by his hard work and by the help of his friends, he have to save his position. So generally, you know, Chitra people in high managerial positions are not having very peaceful professional life, because their authority, you know, at any point of time, their authority is challenged, right? So if Chitra is a parent, they generally have a child which is very argumentative and difficult to deal with. Their spouse is also very argumentative and difficult to deal with, which generally challenges their, you know, which generally challenges their way of working, etc. There are a few traits for Indra. Along with this challenging of power that happens with Indra very often, which is also supposed to happen with Chitra people very often, the challenge of power. There is one more important thing with Indra, that he lures behind woman. So multiple relationships, sometimes extramarital, or you know the particular trait that I was talking about, right? Being fascinated by the previous spouse, even in the new relationship, can be an issue. It is generally a person who is surrounded by the people of opposite gender. And if it is good, Chitra, in that scenario, the person can also be supported by people of the opposite gender. Right? Chitra people are very good with their subordinates, and they help them in every possible way to grow. Even to their distant relatives, they will want to do everything for their betterment. Right? They are generally people who are very liberal with food and donating food, the donation of food, or, you know, like supporting underprivileged people to get the basic amenities of life, they do. Right, they can also have a bad habit of drinking alcohol and liquor. If not, then it is very good for them. But alcoholism is like very bad. Generally, Chitra people are into this particular thing of drinking alcohol, and they don't practice discrimination in food, which may lead to multiple problems from obesity to food poisoning. Right. The person is a good leader, and the person generally works in the position of leadership, where he have to support a group of people, where he have to guide a group of people. That is the best role for him. So rather than being in a managerial position, better for this person is to be as a team leader. And he should learn how to take challenges in a constructive way. Otherwise, this becomes very problematic with his life. Right? Chitra is very good for money. So if the second lord, 11th lord, 5th lord or 9th lord is in Chitra, then it is very good for money, makes a person wealthy and rich, affluent, etc. This is a person who generally loves distributing knowledge. Whatever they have, whatever they have learned through their experience, they have a very strong desire to share this with world. So generally indicates people who want to, as I told you, it is an open book. So generally, people who want to share their life and life experiences with people generally indicates people who are very much interested in blogging, writing books, or making vlogs, or telling their stories to people, telling their experiences to people. Very, you know, like people who are very much into Quora, or, you know, writing posts, etc., to enlighten about their experiences. Very good for internet success.
Sir, I just had a look because I heard previously that Vishwakarma is devata of Chitra. I heard previously.
Vishwakarma is the Indra. The shloka is Indrasya Chitra. So Vishwakarma, I don't think is the lord of this.
Indra is of Jyeshtha, no?
Yeah, Indra is of Jyeshtha. Indra is also of Jyeshtha. Actually, the Taittiriya Brahman, from where we are taking this particular shloka, Taittiriya Brahman takes Indra as the lord of Chitra, Indra as the lord of Jishtha, and Indra as the lord of Sadvishan. So in Jishtha, Indra is as a ruler. In Chitra, Indra is as the provider of grains. And in Shatabisha, Indra is as healer. So that is, this Taittiriya Brahman. And why it doesn't mention Vishwakarma? Because Vishwakarma is a very latent identity. In the Vedic text, specifically Vedas, etc., Vishwakarma is not there. The world is created by Prajapati. Vishwakarma comes at a very later stage in the Puranas level for this particular thing. And Chitra also indicates that trait of, you must have heard this in the story of the Shiva, that there comes a beam of light and the Vishnu and Brahma both are in the duty to find the end of the particular thing. That is also something related to Chitra. So the person is generally confronted by people or confronted by a situation which is way beyond his control. And in that scenario, the person have to be patient enough to reach to a conclusion after analysis. And if the Chitra person jumps to a conclusion quite early, that can be detrimental and problem creating. Now, coming to the remedies part, I will tell you three remedies. The first remedy for Indra will be to worship Indra. And I know that many of us don't do. And let me tell you something from my experience. If I have to give you one remedy to come out of financial trouble, that will be to worship Indra. Right? So you can worship Indra by three ways. Either you can have an image of Indra printed. You can get it. You can get an image of Indra printed, keep it in your temple and show a lamp to that Indra, or you can also have an idol of Indra that is easily available on Amazon. Right. I do have one, so telling you. Okay, that is thing. First, having an image of Indra and worshipping Indra, you don't have to go with a peculiar mantra for Indra. You can just, make a normal thing of like, we worship the... You can just make a normal prayer that we worship the king of God Indra, you be benevolent to us, and that will be sufficient for the worship of Indra. The first remedy that I will tell, the worship of Indra, that is very essential. Another thing is when you do a worship, and you don't ask for any favor in return from the deity, that worship is enjoyed by Indra. So generally, Chitra people should be in a habit of worshipping the deities and not asking something in return. If you do stotras, read the stotra, but don't read the Falashruti. Because generally, Falashruti are the prayers which shed light on what do we want from this particular worship. Right? The third remedy for Indra is to, plant trees and water them. Because Indra is endowed with the duty of watering the earth. So three remedies. In that for Chitra, flower trees are very essential. Also, if you have Jupiter influencing your fifth house or ninth house or ascendant or the fourth house in that scenario, you should at least have two, three flowers planted at your home at every point of time. Flower remedies are very essential if you want to, if you want to remedy moon, or if you want to remedy karmas, or if you want to, encounter karmas quickly, if you want to just quickly come across all the karma and get free from the karmic chain, then planting a specific type of flower and watering that plant is very essential. That is one of the very hidden deeper aspects of Parampara astrology that I am very sure I will not be teaching you at any point of time. So, okay. The Pada of Chitra. The first Pada of Chitra is Virgo sign, Leo Navamsha. Right. Problematic for health. The person wants to live in isolation, doesn't want to connect with people, doesn't want to connect with society. Self-ingrained, self-engrossed, highly focused on family. This is a person who is very much focused on how to uplift my family, how to better the condition of my family, etc. Generally sleep disorders will be there. The person will have a very haphazard working schedule. Along with that, the person will also have problems related to sleeping. The person may frequently see dreams, and there are very strong chances that the person will see, you know, like future events in dream. Okay, it is bad for professional success. Although the person is very careful, very caring about his family, the family doesn't come to any support. Family is more like a burden to this person only. Generally, such people gets fined by the government without any appropriate reason. So losses through government, getting fined by government, getting fined by income tax, loss of money through government, or loss of money through, fraudulent activities is something that is indicated by the Chitra first pada. This is a person who is spiritually advanced, generally concerned with their spiritual development, very religious. The starting part of life is filled with health troubles. And the person is not very well versed in the science of behavior, right? And they generally have to come across very uneasy circumstances in life because their behavior was not appropriate for that particular moment. Along with this, the person is intelligent, academic life is good, the person is quite learned and becomes well-to-do after the age of 27, 28. And the person is very beautiful, fair in complexion, tall in stature, will have a charming eyes. The person will be fierce, honorable, he will have long and stout arms and will have brown hair. For the Chitra first pada. The Chitra.
Sorry, sir, I didn't interrupt. Yeah, wo. Main bata raha tha mera hai Chitra first pada.
Aisa hua ki fir?
Sir, sab kuch sahi hai, bas wo fair complexion wagera ko chhod ke. Wo to ab baki sab sara sahi hai. Starting life kaafi health problems rahe the. Aur अकेडमिक लाइफ भी अच्छी रही थी, बाकी आपने सब जैसा बोला वो सारा ट्रू है।
कॉम्प्लेक्शन इज मोर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द नवांश ऑफ द एसेंडेंट। फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्शन वी शुड गो विद द नक्षत्र ऑफ नवांश लग्न। सॉरी, फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्शन वी शुड गो विद द नक्षत्र ऑफ द एसेंडेंट। द मून नक्षत्र मोर डिसाइड्स द इवेंट्स एंड द मेंटालिटी रेदर देन द कॉम्प्लेक्शन। Yes. Chitra second pada. Professional success guarantee. The person is a good achiever in his professional life. People want to follow him. The person is quite famous. The person is scholarly, well learned, well behaved, good in mathematics, does well in life. The personal life is haphazard. Marital life is a trouble and problem. Family generally doesn't support. The person have to do things on his own. Professional life is very good. Personal life is completely checkered. Right. And the problem is as such that even the person cannot discuss his problems with anyone. Right. And these are few of the things. The person is learned, scholarly. There is one person can have breathing issues or issues related to chest. Right. The person is like, talkative. Attractive, handsome, charming. I will not use the word beautiful, charming. Along with this, the person leads a very unsettled life. Right? And he is generally troubled because of his own mind, which keeps on jumping from one matter to another matter. His mind is never able to think on one thing very constantly. and because of that particular trait the person is troubled, right? If there are litigations in his life, that is very good. He will earn a good amount of money through litigations, right? He should never be afraid of fights. Fights are always good for this person only. Generally, it indicates a life filled up of travels and unsettlement. The person will be famous, will have charming physique, broad eyes, incomparable vigor, will be skillful, be with stooping shoulders, and will be a learned writer. And there can be problems related to progeny. The progeny can be delayed, or there can be some abortions, or there can be no progeny at all. Pradulji, what are you saying?
सर वो एक फैन है उसमें नाम तो उसका चित्रा टू का है असेंडेंट है तो उसको अस्थमा का इशू है तो आप बता रहे थे ब्रीथिंग इशू है तो इसका एक चीज सर मैं और बताऊंगा अभी आपने ऐसे चित्रा पढ़ा के वन में बताया ना कि गवर्नमेंट से प्रॉब्लम होता है तो ये लॉसेस होते हैं तो मेरे साथ ना क्या था कि अगर 10,000 लोग निकल के जा रहे होंगे ना बिना हेलमेट के रोड पे ठीक है तो पुलिस वाला ना किसी को नहीं पकड़ेगा वो सिर्फ ना मुझे पकड़ेगा ठीक है और ये चीज ना मतलब मैंने बहुत नोटिस करी थी तो मैंने अपने चार्ट में ना पहले देख रखी थी आप यकीन नहीं मानेंगे जब मेरा अगर किसी साल में जब मैं कुछ कमाता भी नहीं था ना तब भी आईटीआर भर रहा होता था क्योंकि मैंने कोई चांस ही नहीं लेता गवर्नमेंट से रिलेटेड वाला
पुलिस मैन कैन सी ना चित्रा पधावन चित्रा कमिंग क्या इज दिस चित्रा
बहुत ज्यादा मतलब इतने चालान कटे ना सर मेरे मतलब अगर मैं उसको इकट्ठा कर लू ना तो मैं फोन खरीद दू
सर आई नो चित्रा पदा टू पर्सन वेरी वेरी क्लोज टू मी एंड लिव्स विथ मी ओनली वेरी सीनियर टू मी एंड हैज हेल्प मी अ लॉट सो वेरी आपने चित्रा नक्षत्र के जो जनरल वो ट्रेड्स बताए मैक्सिमम फिट मैक्सिमम एंड इफ चित्रा पदा टू वर्गोत्तम बिकॉज पदा टू इज वर्गोत्तम आल्सो स्टूपिंग शोल्डर्स मतलब इट इज पहली चीज विच यू कैन सी ही स्टूपिंग शोल्डर्स एंड ही हैज सम प्रॉब्लम इन द बैक नर्व्स इन बैक
मर्करी इज द कार का फॉर नर्व्स एज वेल आई थिंक यू मे बी फॉरगॉट अ पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट
His Mercury is very much exalted also in the first. So, maybe.
Mercury exaltation, unsettlement in life, sure.
Achha, achha. Yeah, unsettled life.
Unsettled.
Sir, is there a possible any planet in Chitra in Virgo sign, he will have a fire issue?
Yes, it's very much possible because the biggest enemy of Mercury is Mars. So Chitra second pada is very like you know very prominent to fire issue and even like fire issues either it is a real fire accident happening or burning happening or at least problem with the stomach jashalagni problem with the stomach and digestion happening with it because the biggest enemy for Mercury is Mars.
Yeah I saw the moon in Chitra his mother was burnt.
That was the thing, na, from Golgandan's particular thing. So that is Chitra third pada and Chitra second pada both have this particular trait of. This particular. So Mirdulaji, the results are also correct for your chart?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Chitra pada 3. Once again, because Chitra Pada 3 is also Vargottam, it carries the same trait of excellent professional life. Okay, people want to follow him in his profession, quite influential, famous, well-to-do in professional life. And for this Chitra Pada 3, because it is Libra Vargottam, personal life is also very good. So it is a complete balance between the professional life and personal life. The professional life is extremely good. Personal life is only tolerably good. The person generally finds the love of his life, will go an extra mile with that love of the life, just in the end to find out that all the hard work that I did was futile, even if I did a small amount, lesser hard work, that must also have been achieved. But still, the personal life is beautiful, the professional life is beautiful, things are good. the authority is specifically challenged. Riku is his father burnt in work, son in first pada. Yes, Riku. So Mercury's biggest enemy is Mars. So with Chitra Pada 1 and Chitra Pada 2, this particular thing is there. The burning is there.
Sir, I have a mark with the burn.
You have a
mark in the matlab mere ko itna mark pad gaya burning ki wajah se, maine aag mein jaake haath hi dal diya tha.
Yes. Burning is there with Virgo, hai Marganji? Burning is there with Virgo. We did it in mastering the rashis.
If Virgo is afflicted, then there could be problems of burning.
Virgo afflicted, problems of burning because Virgo lady have fire in her hands.
Eighth house is Aries also
from Virgo. That particular thing is there. We did it in mastering the rashis way back then. Right. So the Chitra third pada. Balanced life, right? The professional life is very good. Personal life is also okay. Person finds the love of his life. Generally indicates multiple affairs. In a positive way, it indicates person being popular in the people of opposite gender. In negative sense, it indicates someone having multiple affairs. The authority of the person is challenged. The spouse, the child, and even the subordinates are not very cooperative with this person. They generally are very, like, you know, disturbing, challenging, problem creating, nuisance creators in his life. But still, he somehow manages to sail across all of these things. Chitra Pada 3, there can be problem related to progeny because once again, Alpaputra Rashi. And, right, so there can be problem related to progeny, delayed progeny, loss of progeny or no progeny at all. Right, generally marriage is also late. And the person have very finer choices, lives a good, affluent, rich life, is given to comforts, and he love comforts, he also get comforts in life. It's not like he's not getting comforts, he's also getting comforts in life, and he loves comfort a lot. The happiness from convenience and vehicle is like, you know, like available from very early age. But the home part, the lands and properties part is a problem. The person should never purchase a land to make a home. He should always purchase a home which is already built. An old home he should purchase and he can renovate it. But purchasing a new property to make a home is detrimental. That is something that I will not recommend for Chitra Pada 3. Along with this, the person is rich. Money is in good amounts. Chitra Pada 3, money is there very strongly. Money is good. Money is strong. Right, the relation, the mother is very supportive. The person also manages to get good amount of income from money from parents, specifically mother, also gains money through inheritance. I was burned at the age of 7, leaving a lifelong scar on my right thigh, had such a major impact on my psyche that I was, and still am in some way, apprehensive of fire, have trouble even lighting a matches. So I think this is AS. AS, you have Virgo afflicted? Saturn, Chitra Pada 2, Atmakarak. And Mars Hasta Pada 3. Yeah, that is because of Mars and Saturn in Virgo. Mars in Virgo, though, never good. So that is because of that particular thing.
Sir, I have a chart. Is chart mein, if we use the normal Lahiri Ayanamsha, then Moon goes to 8th house, Libra, 1st Navamsh, Virgottam. And if we use the Chandrahari Ayanamsha, it is in 7th house, Virgo, last Navamsha, Virgottam. So how to decide?
Check the traits of either the second pada of Chitra or third pada of Chitra. Balanced personal life or haphazard personal life, that will tell you.
In 8th house, Ketu is also there. So moon ketu conjunction also happen.
If the person had some strong accident in childhood only, then moon nirta also.
Achha.
Strong childhood accident. Yeah, some people have, some people go through harassment, some people go through some other thing. Na? So as moon in 8th house, there's a very peculiar trait that there will be a very strong accident in, like before the age of 20, 25, that will, you know, leave a very strong mental or physical restriction on the person. How is the relationship of the person?
The person has good relationship with wife. His father left in early age. I can give the chart if you...
Father left in early age, moon have to be in 7th house. And good relationship with wife also moon 7th house. Like playboy kind of a person or normal?
Not, he's not playboy person. He's a...
Had multiple relationships before marriage?
No, like, you know, when a person is in MBA college, he has, you know, he flirts with many girls, but not any, you know, physical
moon
contact.
Moon in the 7th house also from the MBA, na? Because moon influencing the ascendant, moon is... Vaishya, so MBA.
Yeah.
And moon in the 7th house should indicate wife, white in complexion, belonging from a good family. And because moon influencing the ascendant, that means to, that should indicate that mother have a very strong influence, that is father being absent. Yeah, expert at playing mind games, moon guy, at least in 5-6. Yeah, that is there. Yeah. Moon in the 7th house. Let me tell you. Marry anyone, not moon in 7th house. Marry a tree instead. Moon in 7th house, no. Marriage, never.
लोग कहते हैं कि राहु 7th हाउस में ना बहुत खराब होता है. मैं कहता हूँ मून मिल गया ना किसी को तो और ज्यादा खराब है.
किस में राहु खराब होता है?
सर राहु 7th में मिल जाए तो वो अपने बोलते रहते हैं ना कि
राहु 7th हाउस वेरी गुड. Like Rahu 7th house, Rahu, Mars, Saturn in the 7th house, very good, most welcome. Rahu, Mars, Saturn in the 7th house, extremely good. Oh, we'll love to see such.
नहीं सर, that's what I'm saying. But generally जो एक typical dogma चलता है ना, स्वादिष्ट के बीच है, Rahu 7th house बहुत खराब है, बुरा है. Moon को देख के बहुत खुश हो जाता है. मैंने तो जितने chart देखे ना, Moon वाले ना, मतलब एक मौका नहीं छोड़ते cheat करने का. अगर अफ्लेक्टेड हो जाए तो एक मौका नहीं छोड़ते.
There is a saying, in the Muhurta chart, if moon is in the 7th house or if moon is with the any other planet in marriage Muhurta chart, then that person will always be on the mind of the lady. So there should be no one on the mind of the lady. So moon alone, very good. Let me look. Three most detrimental planets in the 7th house, Jupiter, Moon, Mercury. I'm like, no. Jupiter, Moon, Mercury in the 7th house. Dur sahi. Far away. Okay. Thank you. Rahu, Saturn, Mars in 7th house. Very good. Saturn, Mars combination in 7th house. Brilliant. Oh, very good. Because the person knows the bad karmas that he have done. He is well realized of the bad karmas that he have done. The person will always be like, oh, you got angry from me. That is my own fault. What a good person he is. So that is malefics in the 7th house. Personally, is very good as compared to Mercury or Moon or Jupiter in the 7th house. Not very
good. Sir, I have a one more question, that. So this person has a Chitra first pada also. Mm-hmm. And he has a sleeping paralysis disorder.
Sleeping paralysis disorder. That is the sleeping issues to be discussed in the Chitra Pada, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And for the physical traits for Chitra Pada 3 is that the native will be fair complexion, will have broad eyes, he will be praiseworthy, he will have long face, very skillful in business, will be happy, will be famous. Coming to Chitra Pada 4, trouble for marriage. Chitra Pada 4, trouble for marriage. Either the mother dies early or mother shows no affection to this particular child or the relationship with mother is estranged. The person will have to struggle in his professional life. The person will have to struggle for money. the person can be you know, the person can have a negative outlook towards life, the person can be depressed, he will always be under high level of mental pressure, he will never be able to live happily. Okay, the person is generally taken care by some other relative of mother rather than being taken care by the mother. Chitra fourth pada generally comes up with a trait where the mother is working and some other relative of mother takes care of the child, generally the maternal family. For professional life, it can be okay. It is okay after a particular time, but finances, mental peace, and personal life is highly disturbed. Right? The person generally makes a whole lot of planning, but execution part is not there. And along with this, there can be troubles related to water, right? So either it is trouble from water or trouble due to excessive water in the body through obesity or diarrhea, etc. That can be a problem, right? The person's life is very unstable. You know, the person will not be able to settle in life. And once they start settling up, then there will be the change of place, change of residence, transfer, etc. Such things will come. Right. So the problems from water, there can be some phobia. And the person may believe on something that is not really there. Phobia is very strong. The person is generally prejudiced because of something, and that prejudice can create multiple problems. The life is very haphazard. Generally, the person is not able to settle at a particular place. There will be a lot of promotions, travels, or transfers in the native's life, which will make it very difficult for the person to settle down. Right? The person is secretive, doesn't want to share. The person will be like, you know, he will always say you one thing, that whenever I share something, if I want to do something and if I share it to people, I am not able to do that, or that particular thing gets ruined. Okay. That is there with the third pada, fourth pada of Chitra. Yes, Pratul, your feedback.
Sir, ek chart hai mere paas. Isme Chitra fourth pada mein Mercury hai. उस बंदे का तो और भी उसके कुछ कॉम्बिनेशन बैठ रहे थे, तो मैंने बस पूछ लिया था कि लंग्स रिलेटेड कुछ इशू है क्या भाई का, तो उसने बताया था कि पानी भर गया। तभी मैंने चेक किया मर्करी उसका ना चित्रा फोर में,
मर्करी इन चित्रा फोर में, वाटर इन लंग्स, एंड दैट इज अ वेरी कॉमन प्रॉब्लम जनरली हैपेंस। यस ओके, अलोंग विद दिस the person's family doesn't support him, comes from a family which becomes more a liability on the person rather than being an asset. Even if they are not the liability, even if he belongs from a good family, family people will want to help him but will not be able to do so. The person should be in Krishna bhakti. That is the only way for this person, right? And the person will have squint, round eyes, squint mane banga, or something which is very close, close eyes, round eyes. The person will have elevated teeth, ill-formed also. The person will have depressed waist, charming neck, large heart or broad chest is what you should say. Or some enlargement kind of issues with heart can happen, you know, like heart problems generally indicates heart attack, cholesterol problems, or the use of pacemakers, etc. The person have an ugly body and compact eyebrows. The head is a bit narrow. And the only issue with Chitra Pada 4 is mind. The mind is not in a good condition. Mind is not healthy. The thoughts are negative. The thinking is negative. And the person never takes anything in a joyous way. Never takes anything in a positive way. The person generally takes things in a negative way, which is very detrimental for his own growth. Right, that's all for Chitra. We'll meet in the next class with the next nakshatra. Thank you. Yes,
sir. So, मेरे पास मैंने जैसे इसमें काम करता हूँ voice over industry वगैरह में music में, मेरे पास बहुत सारे voice over artists और singers वगैरह आते हैं। तो एक person है, तो she's a very good voice over artist. But I think sir आपने good voice third में बोला था ना, पहले third में। हाँ, तो उसका सर जो मर्करी है वो चित्रा थर्ड में है, So why so that a good voice?
Why third pada of Chitra is good voice? Because that is Venus Vargottam, Libra Vargottam. So Venusian qualities, na, artistic talents, artistic skills have to be there. Venus is all art.
तो वही जो नेटफ्लिक्स की जितनी मूवीज होती उसमें वो डब करती है हिंदी मतलब जो अपन मूवीज चेक करते
डबिंग डबिंग कम्स डबिंग शुड कम इनटू चित्रा चित्रा डिस्क्रिप्टिव नहीं यस थैंक्स फॉर द फीडबैक